So now in this video, before transformer, we are now going to start with the short concept on how to increase the magnitude of this induced EMF or the current in the case of AC generator. So let us just start with the ways of increasing the magnitude of induced EMF, or we would say current, in case of AC generator. The concept is pretty much same as that we have discussed in DC motor. The first thing is, by increasing the strength of magnetic field. If the magnetic field is going to increase, the change in the magnetic flux would also be increased. And if the change is increased, then we would say the amount of the EMF produced is also increased. Next is by increasing the number of turns. If the number of turns is going to increase, the flux linked with the coil will also increase, and hence the change would also increase, and thus the EMF will also increase. Third case is by increasing the area of the coil. By increasing the area of the coil. See, by increasing the area of coil, again, the EMF, by increasing the area of the coil, the amount of the flux linked with the coil increases. And with that increase, when it is going to change, the change will be maximum, and hence the induced EMF will also be maximum. Third thing is, by increasing the speed of rotation. By increasing the speed of rotation of coil. Now, from the Faraday's law, it is very, very evident that EMF is equals to rate of change of flux. So, we have already discussed in that part, in order to increase the EMF, we'll have to either increase the flux, that is going to be benefited by these three things, and the second very important thing is by decreasing the time. If the time of changing the flux is going to decrease, then EMF will be increased. So, this is done by increasing the speed of rotation. If speed of rotation is going to increase, the time which is required to change the flux, it decreases. The flux is going to change very rapidly. So it means the time to change the flux is decreased, and hence the EMF is increased. So these are some of the ways of increasing the magnitude of the induced EMF or the current. So in the next part, we are going to start with the similarities and dissimilarities between AC generator and DC motor. So now we are going to start with the difference part of the AC generator and DC motor, that how they are differentiated. So here I am writing about AC generator. Here we will talk about DC motor. So let us start. AC generator is a device in which mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. Here mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. In DC motor, this case is reversed. In this, electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. Electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. Now, the second difference. The second difference is that the constructional difference, in AC generator we are using two complete slip rings. We are using two complete slip rings, but in this case we are using two halves of single ring. Here we are using two halves of a single ring, means two splitted parts of a single ring, and here we are using two complete slip rings. This is known as commutator. This is known as commutator, that we have already discussed. The third difference between AC generator and DC motor is its principle. AC generator is based on electromagnetic induction, whereas DC motor is based on the principle that when a current carrying conductor is placed in magnetic field, it will experience a force. So this is the principal difference between these two. So these are the three differences between AC generator and DC motor. How the energy conversion is going to take place, the constructional difference of the rings, and then is the principle on which AC generator and DC motor are based. So these are the differences part of the AC generator and DC motor. Now let us start with the similarities between AC generator and DC motor. Similarities between AC generator and DC motor. So first similarity is that in both the devices, coil rotates between the magnetic field. As we have seen in the working portion, in both the cases, the coil rotates between the magnetic field. The next similarity is that there is some sort of energy conversion that is taking place. So there is some sort of the energy conversion which is taking place. Now, in case of AC generator, the energy conversion is from mechanical to electrical. In DC motor, it is from electrical to mechanical. But still, there is some sort of the energy conversion which is taking place. And the second similarity is in both the cases, the coil rotates between the magnetic field, whether that is an input rotation or the output rotation. In the case of AC generator, we are making the coil to rotate, and in DC motor, the output which we are getting is the rotational motion of the coil. But in both the cases, the coil rotates between the magnetic field and there is some sort of the energy conversion which is taking place. So these are the two similarities between AC generator and DC motor. So from the next video, we are going to start with the last part of the chapter as transformers.